I will persist until I succeed. In the Orient, young bulls are tested for the fight arena in a certain manner. Each is brought to the ring and allowed to attack a picador who pricks them with a lance. The bravery of each bull is then rated with care according to the number of times he demonstrates his willingness to charge in spite of the sting of the blade. Henceforth will I recognize that each day I am tested by life in like manner, if I persist, if I continue to try, if I continue to charge forward, I will succeed. I was not delivered unto this world in defeat, nor does failure course in my veins. I am not a sheep waiting to be prodded by my shepherd. I am a lion, and I refuse to talk, to walk, to sleep with sheep. I will not hear those who weep and complain, for their disease is contagious. Let them join the sheep. The slaughterhouse of failure is not my destiny. The prizes of life are at the end of each journey, not near the beginning, and it is not given to me to know how many steps are necessary in order to reach my goal. Failure I may still encounter at the 1,000th step, yet success hides behind the next bend in the road. Never will I know how close it lies unless I turn the corner. Always will I take another step. If that is of no avail, I will take another, and yet another. In truth, one step at a time is not too difficult. I will persist until I succeed.
Tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside, and something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever.
The margin for error is so small. I mean, one half a step too late or too early, you don't quite make it. One half second too slow, too fast, you don't quite catch it. The inches we need are everywhere around us. They're in every break of the game, every minute, every second.
You got a dream, you got to protect it. People can't do something themselves, they want to tell you you can't. Want something, go get it. Here.
Don't be afraid to fail. You can't always win, but don't be afraid of making decisions.
You have to believe that something different can happen. He who says he can and he who says he can't are both usually right.
that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want to party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us.
Dig deep down, ask yourselves, who do you want to be? Figuring out for yourselves what makes you happy, no matter how crazy it may sound to the people.
Make a choice, right? You just decide what it's going to be, who you're going to be, how you're going to do it. Just decide.
Why not? Why can't I be the MVP of the league? Why can't I be the best player in the league? See why can't I do that?
What is it you said to the kid? It ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward.
Get up. And don't ever give up.
We can stay here, get the shit kicked out of us, or we can fight our way back into the light. We can climb out of hell. One inch at a time.
To be able at any moment to sacrifice what you are for what you will become. Most of you won't be successful because when you're studying and you get tired, you quit. I don't do well in math. You're right. You ain't never studied. I'm not good in writing because you have never written before.
Talent you have naturally. Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of beating on your craft.
If you are not making someone else's life better, then you're wasting your time.
Don't cry to give up. Cry to keep going. Don't cry to quit. You already in pain. You already hurt. Get a reward from it.
Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not point the finger saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that and that ain't you. You're better than that.
Because every day is a new day. Every moment is a new moment. So now you got to go out and show them that I'm a different creature now.
I'm going to show you how great I am.
The 17th chapter of St. Luke is written, the kingdom of God is within man, not one man nor a group of men, but in all men, in you. You, the people, have the power to create machines, the power to create happiness. You, the people, have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure.
Now, what are you going to do?
Your game plan for everybody is, you're born, have fun till you're about 6, maybe 8, go to school, they wipe the fun the fuck out of you, get a job, get a wife at 30, pay your fucking taxes, save up for your retirement, well, the bankers fuck you over for every little piece of money they can get out of you for your whole life, when you're 65 you retire, yippee-ki-yay, then you get to enjoy your life, then you get a heart attack at 68, you die. Your job is to shut the fuck up and not ask questions. Do you know what people start doing when they start asking questions? They start doing things outside the rules. They start making more money. They start quitting their jobs. They start starting businesses and moving offshore. They start fucking multiple girls and not getting married and not getting a house and paying mortgage on the fucking house and paying for the fucking kids. Once you start facing fear every day a little bit, it starts dying. And you start growing. And suddenly you become addicted to that growth. If you guys tune into who you really are, which is an absolutely free entity that loves learning and having fun and being around other people and learning, if you really connected with that child self, which is like all about having fucking fun, you would all quit the system. You guys have to put yourselves first in life, always, because nobody else is going to put your happiness first. Nobody. Ever. You're going to be waiting a long fucking time to be happy, waiting for some shit to happen, because it's not going to happen. You're just going to be 80 and you'll think back to this talk and go, fuck. And then you die. It's a long wait. But that's the disease we've got. We're hoping someone will lead us to happiness. There's two types of human beings. One of them goes for what he wants and moves towards his goal, his objective, and moves towards becoming himself, becoming a man, becoming authentic, becoming more honest, becoming a better person. Every day he's moving towards becoming amazing. The second type of person, he's not. That's it. Which are you?
People ask me all the time, they say to me, what is the secret to success? The first rule is trust yourself. But what is most important is that you have to dig deep down and ask yourselves, who do you want to be? Not what, but who. And I'm talking about not what your parents and teachers want you to be, but you. I'm talking about figuring out for yourselves what makes you happy, no matter how crazy it may sound to the people. Number one is, of course, trust yourself no matter how and what anyone else thinks. And of course, rule number two is break the rules. We have so many rules in life about everything. I say break the rules, not the law, but break the rules. It is impossible to be a maverick or a true original if you're too well behaved and not want to break the rules. You have to think outside the box. That's what I believe, after all. What is the point of being on this earth? All you want to do is be liked by everyone and avoid trouble. The only way that I ever got any place was the breaking some of the rules. Which of course brings me to rule number three. Don't be afraid to fail. Anything I've ever attempted, I was always willing to fail. So you can't always win, but don't be afraid of making decisions. You can't be paralyzed by fear or failure, or you will never push yourself. You keep pushing because you believe in yourself and in your vision, and you know that it is the right thing to do, and success will come. So don't be afraid to fail. Which brings me to rule number four, which is don't listen to the naysayers. I mean, how many times have you heard that you can't do this and you can't do that and it has never been done before? I love it when someone says that no one has ever done this before, because then when I do it, that means that I'm the first one that has done it. So pay no attention to the people that say it can't be done. I never listen that you can't. I always listen to myself and said, yes, you can. And that brings me to rule number five, which is the most important rule of all. Work your butt off. Believe, leaving no stone unturned. Muhammad Ali, one of my great heroes, had a great line in the 70s when he was asked, how many sit-ups do you do? He said, I don't count my sit-ups. I only start counting when it starts hurting. When I feel pain, that's when I start counting, because that's when it really counts. That's what makes you a champion. That's the way it is with everything. No pain, no gain. So, yeah, partying, horsing around. Someone out there at the same time is working hard. Someone is getting smarter and someone is winning. Just remember that. Now, if you want to win, there's absolutely no way around hard work. None of my rules, by the way, of success will work unless you do. I've always figured out that there's 24 hours a day. You sleep 6 hours, and you have 18 hours left. Now, I know there's some of you out there now and says, well, wait a minute, I sleep 8 hours or 9 hours. Well, then just sleep faster, I would recommend. That takes me to rule number six, which is a very important rule. It's about giving back. Whatever path that you take in your lives, you must always find time to give something back. Something back to your community, give something back to your state or to your country. Let me tell you something, reaching out and helping people will bring you more satisfaction than anything else you've ever done. The world. Remember those six rules. Trust yourself, break some rules, don't be afraid to fail, ignore the naysayers, work like hell, and give something back.
When you know within yourself that there's something you want to do, and I believe that all of us were born with a purpose, that all of us have something that we are supposed to do, that all of us have some goodness within us, and that goodness gives us a responsibility to manifest our greatness. Not only is it possible for you to have your dream, but it's necessary. It's necessary that you have it, that you work on it, that you develop yourself, that you go for what is yours in the universe.
Every single day when you wake up, you better be spending time on your dream. You better be spending time on your, you ain't got time to waste. It is a sense of urgency.
It's the character of who you are. It's not the title that makes you. It's not the success that makes you. The character defines the success, defines the fame, and it starts right there. They're one in the thousands of hours in the training room, in the labs, and the 5 a.m. runs, and it's raining, when everyone else is sleeping. That's when it's won. The heart of a champion is a light switch that's always on. It doesn't go on and off when someone's watching. It's constant. It's how you look at something. If your name's attached to it, then you do it right. The best of your ability every single time.
And the problem with some of y'all is you want somebody else to support your dream. It's yours. I don't owe you a dime. It's your dream. If you want it to happen, get your butt up and make it happen. If you want it to happen, rise and grind.
That if you want a thing bad enough to go out and fight for it, to work day and night for it, to give up your time, your peace, and your sleep for it, if all that you dream and scheme is about it, and life seems useless and worthless without it, and if you gladly sweat for it and fret for it and plan for it, and lose all your terror of the opposition for it, and if you simply go after this thing that you want with all of your capacity, strength and sagacity, faith, hope, and confidence, and stern pertinacity, if neither cold poverty, famish, or gout, sickness, or pain, or body and brain can keep you away from the thing that you want.
And the title of 2013, three-time Mr. Olympia, Bill Heath!
Now that's that thing called life. Is that it is always changing. Sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down.
I can tell you that now. Be aware of that. Things are not going to work out exactly right. For a time they will, sometimes. And that's when life is just playing a game with you.
I don't want to play anymore.
I don't care how good you are. I don't care how talented you are. I don't care how much you work on yourself. There are some times when things aren't going to go right. They just are not going to go right. There are times when anything that can happen will happen. But during those down moments, that's where the growth takes place. That's where the work is. Anybody can feel good when they have their health, their bills are paid, they have happy relationships. Anybody could be positive then. Anybody can have a larger vision then. Anybody can have faith under those kinds of circumstances. See, but the real challenge of growth, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, comes when you get knocked down.
And some of you in your life, the reason why you're not blowing up, the reason why you're not successful, you have not learned to pass. You think just because it's an opportunity, is for you, and not every opportunity is for you.
All of us have experienced some tragedy, and if we haven't, we will. And you can either let it destroy your life, or you can build upon it. You can permit it to let it hold you down, or you can decide, I'm not going to let that happen to me. I'm bigger than this. It's not going to be easy. When you want to change, it's not easy. If it were in fact easy, everybody would do it. But if you're serious, you'll go all out.
We all fall down in life. The question is, who gets back up?
It's forgive and grow.
You're about to separate yourself from the pack, and you're about to be on top.
If you want to begin to move into your own personal greatness, you've got to be willing to go against the tide. You've got to be willing to harness your will and say, in spite of this, I'm in control here. I'm not going to let this get me down. I'm not going to let this destroy me.
It's not your circumstances or your situation that determines if you're going to be successful or not. I've been telling you, it's your mindset. It's the way you see it. It's the way you think it.
Your mind is the battleground. Pet somebody and tell them the enemy's after your mind. Out to worry you to death. Out to stress you to death. Out to break you down. Out to make you quit. Out to make you think that you can't get up. Out to make you give up on your dream. The warfare is in your mind. It's not in your checkbook. It's not in your savings account. It's not on your job. The fight that you got to fight is in your mind. And if you whip it in your head, you can whip it in your checkbook. You can whip it on your job. You can whip it out of your children. But you got to try it out of your head.
I'm coming back. And I'll be stronger and better because of it. You have got to make a declaration that this is what you stand for. Standing up for peace of mind. You're standing up for health. You're standing up for your dream. You want it. And you're going to go all out to have it. Let it go and begin to focus on developing myself. And I say to you, you're going to have people to do things to you. Things are going to happen to you. And the most important thing to do is to harness your will and let it go. And move so you can grow. So you can get on with your life. It doesn't matter about what happens to you. What matters is, what are you going to do about it?
When you want something bad, you can't count the cost. Because if you count the cost and you see how much it costs, you might quit. You might give up. So you got to go in knowing that I don't count the cost. I do as many push-ups as it takes, as many sit-ups as it takes, as many reps as it takes. I study as long as it takes. I pay whatever the price is. Why? Because if I start counting the cost, I might quit. I might give up. I might surrender. Don't count the cost. You don't count the cost on this one. You don't count how many breaths you take. You don't count it. You get to a point where you don't count it. You just do whatever it takes to get whatever you want.
Don't stop. Stay busy. Work your plan. Continue to do those things that you know that work for you after you have evaluated yourself and the situation.
Once you make a decision and you go all in and you say, I ain't quitting till I get there. I ain't giving up. I ain't giving in. I'll do whatever it takes to be successful. And when you make that decision, when you look you in the mirror, when you tell yourself that, look, I'm through. I'll do whatever it takes. I guarantee you, that's the day begins to happen. Forget about your past. Forget what happened back in the day. Make the rest of your life the best of your life.
I said, empty your mind. Be formless, shapeless, like water. Now you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put it in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now water can flow, or it can crash. Be water, my friend.
If I tell you I'm good, probably you will say I'm boasting. But if I tell you I'm no good, you know I'm lying.
You know, I have really exhausted, I've depleted my resources.
He was a man now who was, you know, preparing for the biggest bodybuilding show of his life, and he didn't have any income coming in. You know, this was a man who was living on a limited budget. You know, every green bean was accounted for, and every dime he spent was budgeted because he didn't have the money.
After the contest, he broke down and cried on my shoulder, and he said, "I'm glad that you had this Best Poser award, because I have $7 in my pocket, and going home to New York, I wouldn't know what I was going to do with the rest of my life."
Here in New York, the most high green.
This is my life, but this is also me living it.
I think, you know, in the mind of every artist, you know, there's a masterpiece.
Yeah, but I sleep on the floor, you know, in a very small room, focused on making this thing happen.
He is intense. He's very focused. You know, he has his goal set. He's very determined.
Dream for this goal. I've never wanted to do anything else. I've never prayed for any other kind of success.
And if I gotta die tonight, if I gotta die tonight, if this weight is gonna kill me tonight, then so be it.
He doesn't consider failure an option.
Control. Always under control. Always under control. Exactly what I want to do. I found my passion. I've created my true calling in life. I'm living life on my terms.
Does Kai Greene believe he can win this to live become himself?
Absolutely.
Goes to Kai Greene.
He's an unbelievable champion. Kai Greene.
Kai Greene.
Thank God for bodybuilding for Kai Greene.
The question is, can Ed Sandow be on your mantle? Your
dreams are always going to be the most important to you than they will be to anybody else, you know. So keep dreaming, you know, keep believing, keep pressing forward. So to all those warriors out there, be encouraged.
Here he is as a man who grew up with no parents, went from foster home to foster home, you know, had to fend for himself in a very, you know, difficult world, had no parental guidance, had no parental leadership, really had no one advising him on how to be a man or a person in society, in regular society. And here he was now, one of the top bodybuilders in the world.
They can crack jokes, they can sit back and analyze and, you know, criticize and make all the fun they want. But I'm living my life. I'm doing it. What are you?
Our stories.
to fall.
Always burn out physically. Differential of somebody winning and losing has nothing to do with their genetics, has nothing to do with their potential. You're gonna feel this soreness you've never felt before. It's supposed to be that way. It means you're using muscles you haven't used before. Your body's waking up, sharpening your arsenal for perfection of what you can be. But if you didn't know that mentally, you didn't prepare for that, you think something's wrong, maybe it's time to stop. No, it's time to move even further. Even though you go to the gym, you put your time in there, you check the box, yeah, I went to the gym, man, all good. You come back around, you look in the mirror, man, I'm not seeing anything, I'm not seeing anything, I'm not seeing any change at all. Well, because you haven't pushed yourself for your body to have a reason to change. If I gave a valid effort to something, day in, day out, I saw no change, I'd probably quit too. When you embark this journey, you must know that it's going to go down before it comes up. And when it comes up, it's going to go so much higher than you've ever been. Sacrificing today for tomorrow. I couldn't hold myself up. Hit the pavement. I'm okay with that. Because tomorrow I'll get back up and do it again. And I'm going to try to beat my last performance in life. It's not the genetic guy who wins, or the guy with the most potential that wins. It's the person with the greatest perseverance that wins. Always willing to get up and go at it again. Go at it again. That's the guy who has his hand raised later in life, guys. That's the guy you guys need to be. Record everything, what you eat, your training habits, how you feel. You take a picture of yourself on day one, you put it on the mirror. That's who I'll never be again, that's day one, say goodbye to them. Behind that picture, you write down your weight, your height, all your information, your body fat, tape measures around your arms, your waist, your thigh. Record where you've been. And when the struggle gets hard, and you feel like you're not going anywhere, you go back to that day one, re-measure it. It's not an easy path. I'm gonna run a marathon. 90 days out, I'm gonna enter a bodybuilding contest. 90 days out, the family reunion, high school reunion, I'm gonna look my best. 90 days to become that person I wanna be. To turn that dream into a reality, I got 90 days. Today is 1/90th of that opportunity. You guys find a fear, that fear will either create you or destroy you. I love fear. The reason why? Behind every fear is the person you want to be. Fear is self-imposed, meaning it doesn't exist. You create it, you can destroy it too. It's an intangible. If you face your fears, guys, you will realize it's not that big. And once you face it, you go, oh my God, man, I spent all this time running from it. It was so small. If I just faced it, my God, not only did I face it, I beat it back. Energy is never lost, transferred. That negative energy, that fear, is destroyed. It comes back in its confidence. What else am I capable of? What else am I holding my back from that I'm capable of more? What am I running from I don't need to? What else can I overcome? Go after it. You give it all you have. If you lose, at least you try, man. I failed. It's 10 times more of a man than someone said, what if? Because what if never went to the arena.
Pretending that we're satisfied where we are, pretending that everything is okay, pretending that we don't have any special goals or ambitions or desires, when really deep down inside we do really want more. Find out what it is you want and go after it as if your life depends on it. Why? Because it does. It's time for you to look within yourself and decide that I'm in charge of my destiny. I'm in charge here, but is a dream killer. That a lot of things that we want to do, a lot of places we would like to go, a lot of things we would like to experience, and we just stop at but, and we build a case. In fact, I was reading something the other day that talked about but. It says, but is an argument for our limitations, and when we argue for our limitations, we get to keep them. See, but will cause you to procrastinate, but will cause you to hide out behind fear, but will cause you to come up with all type of excuses that you can validate your inaction and not acting on your dream. And right now, more than ever, people need to look for ways to live their dream. People need to look for ways to make it on their own. There is no such thing as job security. There's no such thing as a storm-proof or tragic-proof life. There are no guarantees today, ladies and gentlemen. The illusion is gone. There was a time when we graduated from high school, you're told, go to college and get out, and you go and work for a corporation for 30 or 40 years. They'll give you a gold watch and you'll retire.
That day is gone.
That day is gone, never to return again. So instead of people living in fear, feeling stressed out, feeling powerless, feeling like victims, I think it should be a time that we need to begin to look at ways that we can become an active force in our own lives. Look at ways when we can decide to take charge of our own destiny. Look at ways when we can decide to design a life of substance and begin to truly live our dreams. And it's time for people to decide, I'm ready to get on with my life. Now, you know, a lot of people say, I'm going to live my life one day when things get right. Well, it's hard for me. Have you been and sit in a class yet? Have you signed up yet? No, I haven't. See, a lot of people say no, ladies and gentlemen, to things, and they don't even know what they're saying no to. To build a case on why you can't move on, why you can't grow to the next level, why you can't begin to manifest your greatness, why you can't begin to live life on your terms. Always something there to block you, to keep you where you are, and keep you from beginning to develop your true greatness. Always some fear. How do we handle it? And I'm saying that if you've been hiding out behind but, if you've been using the fact that you don't have enough money or you don't have the education, take it head on. Go get the education. Why don't you decide now that you're going to expand your world, that if other people can learn, you could learn too. People tell you, oh yeah, one day I want to have a restaurant. See, they're pretending they want to go into business for themselves. They're not serious. How can you tell, Les? Watch their actions. Watch what they're doing. The proof is in the pudding. So if you want to do something, if you thought about something you want to do, take it head on. Decide that you're going to face it, that whatever shortcomings you have, that you're going to strengthen yourself there. Whatever training that's required, that you're going to go get that training. But you're going to get started right now. Do what you can, where you are, with what you have, and never be satisfied.
battle for just pure brute strength and determination. Most guys were just pretty much intimidated. They lost the fight before they even got hit, most guys. I knew Artur Skullduggery. These guys, I knew how to beat these guys psychologically before I even got in the ring with them.
As soon as I come into the ring, I'm gloved. No, stop it. That's not true. While I'm in the dressing room, 5 minutes before I come out, my gloves are laced up. I'm breaking my gloves down. I'm pushing the lever in the back of my glove. I'm breaking the middle of the glove so my knuckle could pierce through the leather. I feel my knuckle piercing against the tight leather gloves on the Everlast boxing glove. When I come out, I have supreme confidence, but I'm scared to death. I'm totally afraid. I'm afraid of everything. I'm afraid of losing. I'm afraid of being humiliated, but I'm totally confident. The closer I get to the ring, the more confidence I get. The closer, more confidence I get. All during my training, I've been afraid of this man. I thought this man might be capable of beating me. I've dreamed of him beating me, but I always stayed afraid of him. But the closer I get to the ring, I'm more confident. Once I'm in the ring, I'm a god. No one could beat me. I walk around the ring, but I never take my eyes off my opponent. I keep my eyes on him, even if he's ready and pumping. He can't wait to get his hands on me as well. I keep my eyes on him. Then once I see a chink in his armor, boom, one of his eyes may move, and then I know I have him. Then when he comes to the center of the ring, he still looks at me with his piercing look and as if he's not afraid. But he already made that mistake when he looked down for that 1/10 of a second. I know I had him. He'll fight hard for the first 2 or 3 rounds, but I know I already broke his spirit. During the fight, I'm supremely confident. I'm moving my head. He's throwing punches. I'm making a miss, and I'm countering. I'm hitting him to the body. I'm punching him real hard. And I'm punching, and when I'm punching him, I know he's not able to take my punches. 1, 2, 3 punches. I'm throwing him punches and bunches. He goes down. He's out. I'm victorious. Mike Tyson, greatest fighter that ever lived.
It. I don't know what that dream is that you have. I don't care how far-fetched it might appear to be. I don't care how disappointing it might have been as you've been working toward that dream. But here's what I know. That dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible. See, sometimes we can't say, I can do that. But what we can say, that it's possible. That I can have my dream. as we run toward it, as we work on it day in and day out. And most people don't work on their dreams. Why? They stop growing, they stop working on themselves, they stop stretching, they stop pushing themselves. These are not risk takers. Most people have done all that they're ever going to do. They raise a family, they earn a living, and then they die. But people who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning. That in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain, a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. But in the process of doing that, you will discover some things about yourself that you don't know right now. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you could ever begin to imagine. Align yourself with people that can encourage you, people that can empower you, people that you can learn from, people that you can grow from. Look at your life, look at where you want to go. Don't worry about your circumstances. Don't worry about your age. See, it's time now. If you want to make this your decade, you've got to start saying yes to your life. You've got to start saying yes to your dreams. Yes to your unfolding future. Yes to your potential. Why not? The future is unfolding for you right now. The future is unlimited for you right now. No one knows where you can go. No one knows what you're capable of or what's possible for you. We have the power to change our personal history, changing the direction of our lives, changing our thoughts, changing where we want to go, exploring new horizons. So as you begin to look at this decade and affirming that this is your decade, as you set goals that will make you stretch, that will bring out the best in you, as you begin to remove the negative, toxic people from your life, as you decide to take some chances in life, and that's one of the things that's very important. Viscott said, if you're not willing to risk, you cannot grow. And if you cannot grow, you cannot become your best. And if you cannot become your best, you cannot be happy. And if you can't be happy, then what else is there?
How easy is it to get up in the morning when you know you're not doing all that it takes? It's not very easy at all. You can just lay there awake thinking, oh, what's a few more minutes in bed? It won't matter much anyway. Wrong. It does matter. It will matter. Now, how easy is it to get up in the morning when you're pouring it on, doing the best you can, anxious to get going, make progress toward your dreams? It's a whole different story. When you're resting to renew your reserves, it's much different than resting to avoid your day. When you're psyched up and excited for your life, when you're excited for what you've planned to accomplish for the day, it's amazing. You'll wake up before the alarm clock even tries to startle you awake. Your successes fuel your ambition. Your successes give you extra energy. Your successes pave the way for more successes. It's the snowball effect. With one success, you're excited to meet another, and another, and another. And pretty soon, the disciplines that were so difficult in the beginning, the disciplines that got you going, are now part of your philosophy. How do you know when you're successful? Do you have to be a millionaire? No. If you earn $10,000 a year and that's the best you can do, that's enough. The key is to just do the best you can. If it's $10,000 a year, wonderful. If it's $100,000 a year, wonderful. If it's $1 million a year, wonderful. It doesn't matter $10,000 a year or $1 million a year. It doesn't matter as long as you've done the best you possibly can. Be the most you possibly can, and here's why. The essence of life is growth. here's what's interesting. How tall will a tree grow? Approximately. As tall as it possibly can. You never heard of a tree growing half as high as it could. No, trees don't grow half. Trees send their roots down as deep as possible, stretch their limbs up as high as possible, produce every leaf possible and every fruit possible. Now, why wouldn't human beings strive to their maximum possibility? Here's why. Because we've been given the dignity of choice. It makes us different than alligators and trees and birds. And here's the choice. To become part of what we could be, enough to get by, or to become all that we can be. My best advice for you is to choose the all. Earn all you can, make all the friends you can, read as many books as you can, develop as many skills as you can, see as much as possible, do as much as possible, make as much fortune as possible, give as much of it away as possible. The max, there's no life like it. I'm telling you, once I got on track, I've never looked back. Pick up the challenge, go for it. Take the best of the two easies. Take the route of it's easy to get ahead. It's easy to do all you can. It's easy to succeed. It's easy to have financial freedom. The more you do, the more you get. So the two primary benefits of positive reinforcement are, number one, to build good habits. And number two, to create more energy to fuel your ambitions, your desires, your achievements. Just try to get through the day, never writing anything down, never keeping track of their progress along the way, never really knowing if they are doing all they can to reach their goals, to drive their ambition. But gifted people learn to get from the day. They don't let a day end without picking up some valuable experience, some emotional content, some idea that may positively affect their future. To get the most from a day, to learn the most from a day, you need to be able to reflect on the day. And how can you reflect on a day unless you record it in history?
It's a good idea to start a speech with a joke. Well, don't get your hopes up. I'm not here to tell jokes. I'm here to pick a fight. I'm here to pick a fight with second place. I have about as much patience for second place as I do for flies in my soup. But maybe you like flies in your soup. Maybe you like second place. Maybe you like that you gave it your best, better luck next time, malarkey. They spoon-feed runner-ups. Let me put it another way. If you think second place ain't such a bad deal, why don't you ask Napoleon how he felt about coming in second at Waterloo? Not so good. Not so good. And you can spare me. It's not whether you win or lose or how you play the game bullshit. I guarantee you whoever said that lost the game. Moral of the story? Come in first. Still want to hear a joke? fine. Here's one for you. Knock, knock. Who's there? The guy that finished second. The guy that finished second who? Exactly.